Brookline crash blamed on a mechanic and a botched inspection. Tonight, that mechanic is on trial facing involuntary manslaughter charges. Good evening, I'm Wendy Bell.
And I'm Michelle, right in for Andrew Stocky. Channel 4 Action News reporter Sheldon Ingram is the only reporter in the courtroom when the van's driver took the stand. Sheldon.
Yes, Michelle, just for a second, envision yourself at the top of a hill getting ready to drive down this steep hill. The first thing you want to do is apply your brakes so that you go downhill under control. Well, Jennifer Logan just testified tearfully in front of a jury that when she put a foot on the brake pedal, it went all the way to the floor, and then the van raced downhill out of control. She said she was so frightened she couldn't even scream. All she wanted to do was get that van off of the street so that she wouldn't hit anyone. And then the next instant, she crashed into a tree.
Pittsburgh police say this grinding crash is the result of a van moving downhill with no brakes while carrying two special needs students and a teacher's aide. This man is Mark Fabian. A prosecutor from the district attorney's office says he was the mechanic for A1 bus service the day of the crash. The prosecutor told jurors Fabian was told to fix the brakes on van number 9 that morning, but he only went through the motions and did not do his job. 53-year-old Colleen Visconti died from injuries several days after the crash. Here is what the prosecution will bring out in the trial. Jurors will be told Jennifer Logan complained about the brakes the morning of the crash. Jurors will be told that Fabian lied about conducting an inspection of the brake system. Jurors will also be told that police investigators found leaking brake fluid from the top of the hill leading to the impact point of the crash. Also, investigators say one rear brake was stuck and the other was cracked.
Now, also in a criminal complaint, police tell us that Fabian is not a licensed mechanic. He only received training in VOTEC. In the meantime, Fabian's attorney, in his opening statement, told the jury not to rush to judgment, but listen to all of the testimony. Reporting live from downtown, Sheldon Ingram, Channel 4 Action News.
All right, Sheldon, taking action for you now. Team 4 found out that in Allegheny County alone, state police turned up 612 violations during safety inspections of school buses last year. That includes 67 violations for brake systems, 27 for flashing stop lamps, 20 violations for faulty fire extinguishers, and 6 violations for tires.